street is almost all there is of the village. A double row of cottages, a shop, an inn, and a garage straggle along the old turnpike road. But the village is not modern in other ways. Mrs. Potter, who keeps the village shop, has to draw all her water from the pump. With winter coming on, there's work to be done in the village, and old George Musk repairs the roof of the inn. But there's a wheat crop. Billy knows work on other fields. When the ground has been prepared, the wheat is sown. It is drilled 16 rows at a time by a mechanical driller, day after day, acre after acre, until all the fields are sown. Field of wheat and the end of a working day. In the evening, men come in from the fields and the children from school, among them Anne Potter, the shopkeeper's daughter. The farmer ends his work and goes home to supper. For a few evening hours, the village comes to life, and Billy Stiff meets his fiancée at the fish and chip shop. They've been courting for a year now, and they're going to be married in the village church next spring. Meanwhile, Anne delivers her poster at the inn, where the men drink their beer and talk about their work in the field. In the quiet of his cottage, the foreman has tea with his family. Christmas draws near, the ground is hard and cold. The blades of young wheat are showing like grass over the fields, stretching away in neat lines to the bare hedges. But work at the farm goes on all the year round. This is the season for trimming the hedges that will shield the growing crops. Not all the wheat could be threshed and taken to the mill last harvest time, so lorry loads of grain are sent off all through the winter, and there are turkeys to be fattened for Christmas dinner. There's a lot of paperwork in modern farming, and the farmer has to spend part of every day in his office. Now we must sign forms for Brian, who is going with the lorry to the mill at the market town, some 20 miles away. Andy is going there too, for Christmas shopping. There's to be a party in the village hall, and she has to buy presents for the Christmas tree. Near the road stands the old mill, where the wheat used to be ground years ago. Its two remaining blades still catch the wind and turn it into power, but the days are gone when every view across East Anglia was commanded by a windmill. Town is older than the mill. For centuries it has been the centre where farmers come to sell their crop to buy from the shops and stalls. While Anne is shopping, Brian delivers his papers to the miller and the lorry is unloaded. Here the wheat leaves the farmer's hands and passes into the machinery of the mill. It is blended and rolled, sifted and purified, and finally emerges as flour, the fine white flour that makes our bread and our cakes. It is sent to the bakers in great sacks and to the shops in the small bright bags we all know. And a wedding in the village. Thank you. time for tending the growing crops. The wheat has grown tall enough to hide the rabbits, and the fields are alive with the business of the waking year. The young wheat is sprayed clean of weeds and insects, its roots rolled firmly into the ground. And both work and wedding are surrounded by spring flesh. In the summer, the wheat stands tall and burnished in the sun, ripening towards harvest. Soon all the village will be harvested. But until then, there's time to enjoy the summer days. For a few weeks, the village street is splashed with sunshine. The weeks of summer holidays, ice cream, and bowling matches.
What's your Billy?
Hello, Brian.
Kind this way, Skip. That's a good wood. Ready to wash.
No, a bit too heavy.
Oh, that's nice. It's all wood.
Lovely wood, Cyril.
You lie too.
That's it, chap. A very good guy.
Go on then. Get your water.
Hello, Billy. Coming for a day?
No. I wouldn't mind a drink. Besides, look at that binder working as I know.
When the wheat is ripe, at the end of summer, it has to be reaped and gathered before the day is darkened.